How do I delete and reinstall Microsoft Edge? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Hey, if you're not subscribed to my weekly Confident Computing newsletter, go visit askleo.com/newsletter and sign up today, as soon as this video is over. You'll get weekly comments, answers, tools, tips, tricks, and more, like the answer to today's question. A very common debugging technique, or maybe even a fixing technique, for a program that's acting up is to uninstall it and then reinstall it. Presumably that would fix the various components that may or may not be broken. Unfortunately, when it comes to Edge, you can't. Edge is embedded in Windows in many ways. In some ways, honestly, they're quite frustrating. But the bottom line is that there is no way to uninstall Edge. There are components that Windows relies on that, if they were removed as Edge was removed, would cause pieces of Windows itself to stop working. So what we need to do is try and diagnose, well, whatever the problem is that's causing you to want to uninstall and reinstall Edge. First things first, is it Edge to begin with? I say that because, honestly, I would say over half, easily over half, maybe two-thirds of the problems that manifest in a browser, any browser, aren't really the browser itself, but one of the extensions or add-ons that has been installed. So the very first thing I want you to do is to disable all the add-ons. In Edge, here we are in Edge in my Windows 11, click on the, it looks like kind of a puzzle piece icon. You can click on that, and then we'll click on Manage Extensions. This takes us to the Manage Extensions page. Obviously, I have only one extension installed on this machine. You may have multiple extensions. The thing to do is simply turn off the extension and see if that makes the problem go away. Turn off all the extensions and see if that makes the problem go away. If it does, well, honestly, that's great, because you now know that the problem is caused by an extension. Then, if that happens, turn them on one at a time and see if the problem reappears. When it reappears, then you know that the extension you turned on most recently is the culprit, and you can take appropriate action. If it's not an extension, well, the thing to do then is to scan for malware. The way I do that in Windows is to fire up Windows Security, go over to Virus and Threat Protection. In this case, I use Scan Options and, in fact, do a full scan instead of a quick scan. That will scan the entire machine, everything that happens to be on the C drive, on the system drive, whether or not it's one of the more or less common places that malicious software can appear. Malware can absolutely impact your browser's behavior. Typically, it shows up as a misbehaving extension, but nonetheless, it can still cause problems. So after you've disabled all the extensions and determined that they're not the problem, running a full malware scan is the next thing to do. Now, I do have to point out that I happen to be using Windows Security. You might be using something else. So while I've shown you how to run a full scan in Windows Security, you'll need to understand what the appropriate steps are in whatever tool you happen to be using. So let's say your security scan comes up clean. I'm going to go ahead and cancel this, because the next thing we'll end up doing is running the system file checker. I'm going to run terminal in the admin mode so that I can say SFC/scan now. That will scan all of the files associated with Windows itself and make sure that they are the correct versions and that they haven't been tampered with. If it finds anything amiss, it will attempt to repair the problem. If it does, see if that makes your problem go away. If it does, great. If it doesn't, the next thing to try, I'm not going to run it here because I don't have it in front of me, but there will be a link to it in the article that goes along with this video, is DISM, the Deployment Image Servicing and Management command. It has a number of options for, once again, confirming that Windows itself is properly set up and that everything is as it should be. It too can repair certain things, a few things perhaps that the system file checker won't. And finally, and maybe I should have started with this earlier, but make sure that Windows is up to date. I mean, as up to date as is possible. That means going into settings, I'll go ahead and do it here. Going into settings, going into Windows Update, and essentially just saying check for update until there are no more updates available for you. That way you know you are fully up to date. You know, browser problems can sometimes be caused by bugs. And since Edge is so tightly embedded into Windows, well, the way to update Edge is to update Windows and make sure that it is at its latest version. So, we've tried a lot of things. There is, as it turns out, one way to completely uninstall Edge and reinstall it from scratch. Remember how I said it was so tightly embedded in Windows? Well, that's your clue. The only other scenario to attempting to fix Microsoft Edge is to reinstall Windows from scratch. That, obviously, is painful. And if you'd go that route, please back up it completely first. But it is an option. You can use one of the reset options in Windows to do it for you. Honestly, the more pragmatic solution is if Edge is causing you a problem, don't use it. There are so many other good browsers out there that you don't really need to be tied to using Edge. Yes, there are some cases where Windows is going to insist on bringing up Edge anyway. Not much we can do about that. But to the extent that you're using a browser for your day-to-day work, or your day-to-day email, or whatever, pick a different one. Get Google Chrome, get Mozilla Firefox, get Brave, get one of the others, and see if that doesn't resolve whatever issues are causing you to want to uninstall and reinstall Edge. Because like I said, you can't. Hope that's helpful. For updates, for comments, for links related to the topic and more, visit askleo.com/2366. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.